With Uganda's national budget ballooning from 52.7 trillion shillings in financial year 2023-2024 to 72.1 trillion shillings in financial year 2024-2025, an argument has been made that this presents an opportunity for small and medium enterprises to tap into. An estimated 60% of Uganda's annual budget is spent on public procurement. In the financial year 2024-2025, 72.1 trillion shillings budget, up to 1.6 trillion shillings, has been allocated towards programs that benefit small and medium-sized enterprises. To benefit from these initiatives, experts argue that they need to clean up their houses and get strategic partners that will enable them get funding. Anthony Chituka, the Equity Bank Managing Director, speaks about how women are good at meeting their loan obligations as compared to the men.
Equity on its own is implementing a new project called GROW. Again, but this one, I've got to admit, is mainly for the women entrepreneurs. Now, my friends who are the men, you will forgive me, but from our experience and from what we see, women do not default as much as men. Sibadimba, women do not default. Obugalo for the women.
Chituka also speaks about government's commitment to relaxing the requirements needed to access the small recovery fund administered by commercial banks.
We think you should be looking at effective financial management. I think one of the challenges that we see with the SMEs is around documentation, around structure. Yet some industries like oil and gas, if you want to supply that industry, there's a lot of paperwork. Yet the opportunities are there. As a bank, we are happy to help you, train you, and actually we will be training anybody who wants to enter and supply the oil and gas industry, which is where I have an MBA in. We want to fill that pipeline, to fill that value chain with Ugandan small, medium enterprises. You see, they can import many things, but let me tell you, for example, something they cannot import. You can't import stones, ballast. You can't import stones which will be used for the pipeline. You can try and import food, but they can't import enough food. They can't import so much labor. They can't import hotels. They can't import too many skills. We feel Ugandan SMEs can participate if they have been well-trained to put the right documentation to qualify for those contracts. And Equity is saying we are here to help you. But in that regard, let us train you on proper financial management. We will support you there. Another area we think is find strategic partnerships. I know one of the challenges of SMEs is when you're growing, you don't want to bring in other people to join your company. But I can tell you, one of the richest men in this country told me something very many years ago, and I remember it to this day. And he said, small of big is better than big of small. Small of big is better than big of small. What did he mean? He said, yes, you can grow your business. You can be the MD, the chairman, but at some point, your limit will be that you don't have enough capacity.
Msonga, a solar entrepreneur, notes that there is need to develop a specific loan product like trade financing to address a trader's challenge on accessing financing.
Some of the banks are already providing trade finance. I wouldn't give the names of the banks, but some of the big banks do trade finance. So they actually get you a facility, they give you a limit of what you can access. So when you actually have the business or when you actually have work, you can actually go to them and say, I want to tap into my limit. So the loan doesn't count until you tap into your limit, but you always have it ready. And whenever the business comes, maybe a contract, maybe you have a client across the borders and you want to quickly purchase goods and send to them, you tap into it and the loan starts counting when you've actually tapped into it, instead of getting an open loan where you start paying monthly.
Download the app on App Store or Google Play Store now. Vision Digital Experience, the future of media.